a question about that, of course. And I think that he has earned the title Mighty Big Boy and Andre 3000 collectively. They call themselves Outkast. Sounds good to me, of course. No question about that. So we're doing our thing. I want to welcome everybody to this station. We got our all-digital station together. We're doing our thing, of course, getting a chance to get down with you, and I'm having a great time as I'm doing that. As we, you know, we're smoothing. We're smoothing it out. Even in the daytime, it's all good. I think I want to do it like this. You know, Babyface Big Brother is in this group. Of course, we will lose him in 2019. And may he rest in peace, of course, as we move on, the world turning. We still on it. You woke up breathing, so that means you're doing all right. You're doing good. Let's get down with this classic. No question about it. It's been remixed, sampled, redone, covered. Let's do it, of course. And I think they can earn the title of Mighty, Mighty After 7. L.A. Reid and Babyface people, ready or not, let's do it like this. So we're doing our thing, of course. We're going to get a chance to get a chance to get down with you, of course, as we're doing our thing. Appreciate you. I see that as I'm doing this, I'm going to have to go ahead and, work on, another transition. I have to go ahead and do Troop. I see as I do this thing like this, I have to work with it. It's all good. No question about it. We're going to do it, make it happen. And like I always tell you, anything can happen when you're live. And, I want to discuss two things going on, current events right now. I was having a discussion earlier, and the question was, should we be in a panic? I say absolutely not. Again, I always tell them we survived 600 years here. We done been from the Pharaoh millions of years ago, hundreds of thousands of years ago, till now, 2020. And we're not going to let a pandemic of the flu scare us from living life and enjoying everything. Of course, it's not the first plague or pandemic. It won't be the last. You dig what I'm saying? So the question is, are you scared? That's the question. And the bottom line is, it's your time to go. There will be nothing you can do because it's going to be your time to go. And it's your time to go. That's all you're going to have and all you're going to do is be able to do what you do when it's your time to go. So don't worry about, don't spend life worrying about what if, you enjoy life, you do what you got to do, you take care of your business, you work, you take care of your family, take care of yourself, especially as long as you're able-bodied and independent to be able to do what you can do and not worry about different things that's going on so far as, health is concerned or the concern of what's going on in the world. Make sure you take care of what you got to do. And try to do things that is, a precaution. You know what I mean? If you need to do whatever it is you're doing, make sure you wash your hands. When you go to the restroom, wash your hands. For each wash your hands, as you're touching different devices and even your cell phone, clean that off and do what you got to do. You dig what I'm saying? To try to stay as cool and as clean as you can. That's the bottom line. You dig what I'm saying? Let me get down with this one. Of course, is one of my regular ones. The regular video playlist and audio playlist. Of course, we got different channels in the mix on this. And we got different things that's going on. I'm going to, you know, go a little bit on this so I can go ahead and check the sound, check the level, see where we are. And we're going to come back and we're riding the road. Of course, went up all night. It's been a lot of fun, though. You know, touching base with, you know, the relatives, some of them I haven't heard from in a while. And it was good to touch base, you know what I'm saying, with some of the people that I hadn't heard from or seen in a while. Also, it was fun, you know, doing our all-digital radio show and podcast in real time. That's a lot of fun. I want to do this one, though. Haven't heard it in a while. Sounds good. We're going to get down in the mix. And that transition from After 7 to Troop, you know, again, I tell you, anything can happen when you're live. And this is where we're doing our thing. So, you know, I'm a one take, uncut. You know what I mean? I did a lot of editing for years on my cable show. But here, you know, however it turned out, it's going to be the artistic, rendition of what I'm doing. It's all good, all gravy. Let's do it like this. One of my favorite ones in the mix. The video is cold too, especially the remix. He's in a white suit, redoing it live. That's how you can tell true talent that they can get down when it's a cappella and it's live, right? Let's do it like this. Had to clear my throat on that, of course. We're getting down with Keith Washington for doing our thing. I appreciate you. Let's go ahead and do this, of course, simulcast. That's how we're doing our thing. Let's get down with some more Keith Washington. He called us from Kissing You. It sounded good, of course. Keith Washington. I like that one, of course. That's called Kissing You. You know, I've been doing a little discussion. I've been having a discussion today about all that's going on. My thing is, of course, the world turning, we still on it. And for those of us who are safe and sound, and, you know, we don't have coughs or colds or any viruses or anything to worry about, we're blessed. And we can't, let, you know, that stop you from having an everyday life. You're saying you still got to go take care of what you got to take care of to pay your bills. You still got to maintain what you got to do. You still got to eat. You still got to make it happen. So don't let the presentation of the media scare you. Although it's a real pandemic situation going on, the issue is we got to look at where the root cause is. Anytime you decide to have someone who wants to cut from the CDC, you know, different things that was keeping you safe, all in the name of greed, and you may have to think about that when you go do your vote at the ballot box this time. Don't forget about the scare that you have that you can't even enjoy going out and about because someone chose to cut the budget for the CDC. You dig what I'm saying? All in the name of greed. And as they always say, my grandmother and people, of course, to believe that God don't like ugly. It's all good. You know what I mean? And yeah, we all in this thing together. So you got to be more responsible and more accountable for who we allow is supposed to be the leader of the free world. You know what I mean? Anyway, you get a chance to see what the problem is, where the blame lies. And, you know, hopefully there will be better choices made this election, this round. You dig what I'm saying? Hopefully things will go and get and be better after you go to the ballot box and let your voice be heard. Now, some people, you know, they make the comment, is it really important to vote? Yes, it's absolutely important to vote because people have died for your right to vote. And I know that a lot of times it seems like, you know, your voice is not heard, it's not important. And, election, you know, sometimes when you vote, the election goes your way. And sometimes you vote and the election does not go your way. But as they say, that's just how the cookie crumbles. But that doesn't mean that you need to stop voting. It means that you just need to do your due diligence and do your research. Know where the person that you're voting for stands. With that being said, of course,